beans. Let's talk about beans, bean trading. And let's go to the origin of bean trading and how it got started in the Pathfinder Club. So let's go there. The first thing that I want you to remember, is that the origins of bean trading, it had its origins at the Olympics. Listen to this. At the Olympics, as early as the first modern games in 1896, athletes and officials wore a special badges so they could be visually recognized as representing a specific country. In 1906, Sweden was the first country to use their national color of the badges. So the other countries soon followed and became the standard way of doing things. So then the athletes began wearing pins featuring their national colors, and soon after, the athletes from different countries began exchanging pins with each other as the symbol of unity. Remember, the pins in the Olympics was symbol of diversity, was symbol of unity, and was symbol of friendship and camaraderie. You know, people mingle with themselves, especially the athletes. The athletes were the first one who shared the pins. As time went by, they came the training pins that we're familiar with seeing today, what we've seen today. So, the first time spectators were allowed to collect and trade pins at the Olympics was in 1980. You got to write that down. In 1980, the Olympics gave permission to everybody, the spectators, people traveling from different parts of the world, so they can bring their pins and trade it. So pin trading quickly became very popular, and today it's considered the number one spectator sport of the Olympic Games. So now, let me show you a video of how the Olympics, the modern Olympics began. Just watch the video. All right, so you saw how the Olympics began, later you can see that even in, for example, in Brazil, they were doing a lot of pin trading.
name
Look
is
at this.
Ioannidis. I come from Greece, the beautiful Greece, and I collect pins from Athens 2004. This is my 7th Olympic Games. I travel only for that reason. I like Olympic spirit. I am Greek. Don't forget, Olympic Games start from there. It's small. It's very, very beautiful. They are collectible. My favorite. I don't wear it. It's my home now. But I have everyone its favorite. I like this now. You meet people. You see many countries, many culture. Maybe 100, 150 guys collect pins. But I stay in Paralympics too. Some people, they come only in Olympics. Dinosaur. I have Barcelona Olympic Games. From Argentina, the Olympic rings. American flag, Brazilian flag. 4 different Olympic Games. Everything. Hello, Australia. I like to come to see your big island. Ozzy, oi, oi, oi.
This happened in Rio. So this practice became more and more common, and eventually vendors recognized the demand and began producing pins for trading among the athletes and so on. So let's go quickly the origin of how pin trading is starting in the Pathfinder in the Pathfinder Club. So as you remember, Pathfinder pin trading began at the first the North American division on Pathfinder Camperee at Camp Hill, Colorado in 1985. As you remember, for example, that huge Camperee, which I have a video, but I'm not going to show it to you because the quality was really very poor, so I didn't want to show it. But you can Google it on YouTube, 1985 World Pathfinder Camperee. That's where it started here, moving the costume. Young people and clubs will come from different part of the United States and bring something that will symbolize their culture and their club and so on. So let me just show you two gentlemen that did a great job. As you know, Les Piton or Python and Normie Dad. For example, Lord Python was the North American Division Youth Director, and Normie Dad was assigned as the chairman of the Camperee Coordinated Committee. So the committee decided that as part of the Camperee program, they would ask each club to bring something small, like a pin and other small items that represented the area in which they lived. So Pathfinder from different clubs could then trade items with each other as a way to encourage them to meet new people and new friends. So look at some ancient pictures. Look at some ancient pictures. They were more in handmade pins, plastic pins, and other items than metal pins at the first big Camperee. But quickly it became apparent that the metal pins were more popular on trading items, you know? Okay, so I just want to show you quickly different pictures of people trading pins. You can see here, after this first big Camperee, pin trading became a very popular activity in the international Camperees. As you know, some of you have been in Oshkosh, and that in other Camperees that have been trading pins. So also moving forward into the 90s, what we call the Rose Parade. Normie Dad, our me dad, was also the originator of the 1991, 1992, 1993, what they call Witness to Rose Parade float, sponsored by the Seventh-day Adventist Church in North American Division. So Normie Dad was one of them that participated and created pins on to trade at the Rose Parade. However, It was not until 1996 that this gentleman here, a very talented man, Pastor John Swatford, who was a youth director from the Georgia Cumberland Conference, he, in 1996, began what we call a pin trading school. He introduced that in his school. He made it. One day he visited the Olympics in Atlanta, Georgia. So he saw the pins that Coca-Cola had and all that. So he said, you know, we should implement a school that we can teach the young people how to trade pins. So he decided to start a Pathfinder pin trading school to offer like guidelines to Pathfinders. As some individuals were misusing pin trading. Some people were unsure to do pin trading on the Sabbath or not. So they needed to take some steps and organize themselves. So my Pastor Swatford decided, no, we need to do something. We need to organize something. So let me show you here some of the pins that they had in the past. So the Georgia Cumberland Conference and the Southern Union were very supportive of this idea, and the first Pathfinder Pin Training School was held at the October 1996 Southern Union Camperee in Cherokee, North Carolina. So Pastor John and his family taught this in his first school. And one thing that they had in mind, they had a classroom setting where they promoted the idea of have fun, be fair, and be friendly. These are the three items that I want you to remember when you do pin trading, and I'm going to expand it later. Remember this: have fun, be fair, and be friendly. So, fun, fair, and friendly. I want you to write at this moment, those of you that are on Facebook, please write there fun, fair, and friendly. When you trade the pins, write there, put hashtag fun, fair, and friendly. I'm going to give you 15 seconds. Those of you that are in on Facebook, let me see. Fun, fair, and friendly. The first 10 people that will write it will get a special pin from the General Conference celebrating of the 70th anniversary of Pathfinder Ministry. Fun, fair, and friendly.
Yep. So we have a lot of, people are reacting very quickly. And we have a lot of people on Zoom. So we'll just give a few seconds for the people. Actually, let's give a few seconds for the people who are on the Facebook as well. Let me see what's happening there. All right. It's slowly coming. Yes, we do have it. I will, in order for you to be able to receive this pen, you need to email me your address and the name. So what I'm going to do is I put my email address in the chat and so that we can actually try to mail you this. Of course, keep in mind, it might not happen straight away because of coronavirus, but certainly, send us the email on this address, email address, and we will be able to help you by sending this to you. Pastor Andreas, thank you. Also, Pastor Andreas, just to let you know, British Union Communications Director, Pastor Richard Daly, he is the one who loves Olympic Games. He has 500 Olympics collection pins going from 1994 all the way now.
Excellent. Tell him to please send me a picture of it so I can have it and share it in my presentation.
Sounds good. I'm sure he heard you, but if he hasn't, I'll make sure. I'll ask him to send the picture.
And I will give him a special pin, tell him, okay?
Sounds good.
So, okay, my friends and Pathfinder, those of you on YouTube and those of you who are on Facebook and Zoom, a pin trading school pin, as you can see it on the screen. Graduation certificate, as you can see it on the screen. That's the way they had it there from the Cumberland conference. So now, let's move on. So later in 2013, on 14, what is what more official. But the Pin Trade in Honor was created in 2013 as a way to help Pathfinder to make a good pin trading. And you can see on the screen, right here. These are the two responsible for putting this together, Ted and Betsy Burgdorf are the ones that put this pin trading honor together. So you can see I met them. They are very nice, kind people. They love the young people. And in the middle right there is a friend also who is very, very into pin trading, who is right now in Mexico. And he also print pins and create pins. So these are people that are very good with pins. They created Ted and Bexy this honor. So let me go. I'm gonna show you something quickly. Let me show you my collection. I got this one, but I'm gonna stop my presentation. I'm gonna stop sharing my presentation so I can show you something real quick here. I'm gonna show you something real quick here. I have this one that was given to me by the Mongolian Mission Pathfinders in Mongolia. They gave it to me in Oshkosh. And then you can see in the back, I have some pins. I have my hat here. If you can see, I have pins from different parts of the world with different meanings. All these pins. This is just not to have fun. Yes, we have fun. But this pin for me is memory. It's memory of people and events and circumstances. So when I see this pin, I remember when I was with Adventures and I spent quality time with them. This is not to make money or to waste money. I remember what happened when I see this pin. When I think, for example, about this pin, about compassion, I remember the thousands of people that were touched in the Atlantic Union through this pin, and we serve the community. So it brings memory. So it helps me. One of my mentors who also supported me in the time of travel, I remember because he was spearheading this compassion ministry. So this is memory. If you give me a second, Pastor Dejan, can I bring my other collection? Do you give me permission?
Yeah, Pastor. We would love to see what you have there.
Okay, quickly. This is Melanie. This is my daughter's jacket. This is pins that some people gave her at some Camp Paris. She remembered them. And every time she sees them, she says, oh, he gave me the pin, and so on. So this is Melanie pins. This is my other jacket. I have five jackets. So one is very personal. The other one was my wife gave it to me. And the other one is the one that I used to trade pins. So this is another jacket, a vest. We call it vest of pins. And we have this lanyard that we can use also, and so on. So this is really memory, you see, in the back. And last but not least, let me show you this collection. This is another collection that I have here.
Wow. And I can see they're all chosen, is that right? Chosen collection.
Yeah, this is chosen collection. Most of them, 90%. Yeah, this is a chosen collection. This one I got it here this year. So I really have like 10,000 pins, but I cannot show it to you from different part of the world. This is another one from Chosen and Forever Faithful Camperee, right here. Look at this one.
Wow. And so, Pastor, do you then purchase the boxes and place them there, or?
Yes. I buy the boxes and put it there. Some people create their own boxes. And, you know, there are different ways. I'm going to show you where do you put it. You know, this is a scarf. that I was given in Panama with some of their pins, and so on and so on. Some of them are given to me. Some I have got it for free. Some I have get it on internet. Others I have received it as a gift, and some I bought it. I have bought my but my wife now is telling me not to buy anymore.
That happens to all of us when we get some things too much.
You know, when we, I mean, my wife always tell me, no more books, please. No more books. No more books. And now it's, no more pins, please. No more pins. She's an accountant, so, you know, she's my boss.
You'll understand.
Okay, let me go back to the presentation. And let me show you here, blah, blah, blah. Okay, let me know if you see the screen, my pastor.
Yes, we can. Yes, we can see your screen.
Okay, so I'm gonna show you this quickly, but this is supposed to be for the advanced pin owner. For the advanced pin owner, the type of pins that we have. We have like 8 or 9 type of pins, but I'm just gonna show you 4 of them so you can see it, because in my display maybe it was too maybe too far away. But I'm gonna show it to you right now with that. We got the dangler, the blinkers, the spinner, and the puzzles. You don't need to write that down. I just wanted to show it to you in advance, just in case you want to move on to the advanced pin honor later in the future. But these are different type of honor. In the past, they only had like the plastic ones, and they had the button and so on. But now it has become a more modern items. You know, they do crazy things. I want to create the drone. I want to create it to fly. So my next target for the next camper is to have a pin honor flying everywhere. Okay, don't tell that to anybody. I know nobody's watching at this moment. So please don't steal the idea. So that one that you see, the puzzle, I did that when I was in New York as a youth director. All the bottles from Queens, Manhattan, Brooklyn, Long Island, that was the areas that was divided, the youth ministry. So I made a special pin for each one of them, and then I made a whole puzzle, and that was for the 2014 Forever Faithful Camperee. And people were getting crazy because it was kind of big, but later people start to buy it, and people still looking for it. All right. So let's see. Let's define some items quickly. Let's define some items quickly. Number one is the button. I should have some button here. Give me a second. Blue, 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 blue. I had it here, but it's okay. I'm going to show you the picture. Oh, let me see. Give me a second. I found it. This is a button right here. You can see it on the screen.
Yes, we can.
Okay, you can see there. Some people make it at home. If you go to a YouTube, how to make a button, they have a machine. You can do it very quickly if you want to make it for your own club and all that. So that's a button. You know, they have keychain and all that in different places and so on. So a button can be round, as you know, oval, square, rectangular, or a diamond shape, or come in different sizes. As you can see it on the screen, here, you can see, I put it there, you can see it on the screen. All type of button, different weight. So now, let's go, that is in your sheet. What is a button? Can be round, oval, and so on. So what is a button? It is designed place over a metal shell, and covered with a clear plastic cover. A design placed over a metal shell and covered with a clear plastic cover. The metal or the plastic back has a safety clap or a straight, as you saw it, a straight pin. Bottle can be round and oval. You see the straight pin. Just be very careful. You can put yourself there and you can even harm somebody. So you have to be very careful how
you do it. Yes. Somebody is asking the question, because you are obviously the expert in this, is there a talking pin?
You know, that's a very good question. You know, I have not seen it yet. I have seen pins that make noise, but not with a conversation yet. But you know, I don't doubt that it's out there. Maybe I haven't seen it. I don't doubt that they can put something and put some. I have seen with music and different sound, you know, types. But talking per se, I don't recall at this moment. But
for that's sure, right.
Sure, they should be. It should be there.
Thank you.
But thank you for that. I think that's a good idea. If it's not copyrighted, I could do that too.
Yes.
Okay. So you have a clutch. This is what we call the clutch, a device for gripping or attaching things together. This is a clutch right here. This is a clutch. You can see it on the screen. This is a metal clutch. And then you have a rubber clutch here and metal clutch. This one is very special. I'm not going to talk about it now, this one here. But also, that's a clutch, but that one is more sophisticated, with special pins, more expensive, and all that. So you have that clutch, that gripping device. If you can see it there, you can see it. This is also called butterfly clutch, or it's also called military clutch. The military, they tend to use this one. So you put it there. Just be very careful, okay, with that. All right, family. So there is another term that has nothing to do with pins per se, but it has to do with the way of life. And it's called etiquette. Etiquette. I don't know if I'm pronouncing it correctly in English. Please help me out. Etiquette. And etiquette is the proper conduct or behavior that is usually acceptable for specific situations, such as pin trading. So, you know, there is an etiquette that you practice when you do pin trading. So that is very, very important. And that is in your sheet. Write it down. So let's go to the lanyard. I already show you one. It's on the screen. You can also see it here. It's a cord that hangs around the neck, which can be used for displaying pins. So if you want to do that, you put your lanyard there. Of course, it doesn't look right or beautiful if you have this and this. But if you have just a t-shirt, a polo shirt, and you put this and walk around a camperee, you're just showing them that you really want to trade or to display your pins, okay? My recommendation is, if you're going to display some pins, be willing to trade it. If not, people would get like, come on, you know, why are you showing off if you're not willing to trade? Or if you have a vest or pins that is only for you, that you're not willing to trade, put it on the side. Or if you want to wear it and have it, then have other pins with you so people can, you can do some trading with people. Okay? So that's the lanyard. And you have the pin, that small design, 1 inch, 2 inches, even 4 inches, I've seen, that is usually made of metal with some type of a clutch or clasp in the back to attach its clothing or other items. You already see, this is a pin. This is a regular pin. We did this one for Oshkosh, you know. This one I did it like for a camperee. We talk about the sanctuary. This one we did it for a union here in Mexico. So that's a pin. We have the 70th anniversary pin, and we have two special pins. This is the one that I'm going to give you, the pastor is going to give you, to all of you that participated in Zoom, okay? So if I go to London, I go to your union in September, I'm going to bring some of these so I can give it away. I'm going to bring at least 100 so I can give it away. This is a spinning pin. This one, it spins, and it's really, 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 really nice, okay? All right. Let's move forward. What is a venue? Is the location where an event or action such as a pin trading takes place. So what is a venue? What is a venue? You can write it down there in the chat. What is a venue?
So let's put it in the chat to the people. You know, how do you define the venue? So we can have a good discussion here, everybody. Okay. Pastor Andres, as they come in, I will be sharing this with you.
Okay.
So people are saying it's a place. They're saying it is a place where a certain musical or worship event takes place,
mm-hmm.
where a lot of people gather, place of training or trading, place of gathering of people, venue. So this is what it came through. What else is coming through is, well, they're saying a place where people gather is the most common, a big place, somebody said just.
Yeah. No, no, no. They're right. They're smart, man. These kids are smart. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. So you already know what is the venue. So let's go to identify the two most common type of pin bags and demonstrate or describe how to safely attach and remove them. You already saw that. You already saw that. So this is the you hold this piece and then you hold the clutch, you pull it, you know, and then you press the butterfly, put it in, release it. That's the safe way. And then you have here the rubber one. Just make sure you put it in the middle. Sometimes, you know, you can pinch yourself. I've done it. So you make sure you put it, because sometimes when I wear this, one time I had a friend of mine, I have lost the rubber on clutch, and he hit me here and it really pinched me close to my heart. And this is serious. I was in pain the whole day. So just be very careful and make sure they all have their rubber and so on. People prefer rubber, others prefer the metal clutch, whatever you want to decide. I don't, you know, choose whatever you want. So you can see it on the screen. That's number three. Let's go to number four. Name at least five places where you can get pins for trading, including free or inexpensive pins. Collect at least three of the five pins for trading from one or more of these resources. So let me see. You can, let me show you something here on the screen. Those five places, we're going to go one by one. Quickly, you can get free pins with families and friends, with Pastor Dejan. Every time you see Pastor Dejan, you say, Pastor, do you have a pin for me? Okay? I'm sorry, Pastor. Put you in the middle now.
You're gonna be crazy, Pastor. But this is the British Union pin. In case you don't know it, this is how I need to send some to you, Pastor, as well.
Please,
Pastor. Please. Pastor, if you remember, you gave me this one from the World Leadership Conference in Germany. Yes. I got invested there.
By the way, I have a picture of you in this presentation. Watch, watch.
Okay.
So you can get prints from Pastor Dejan, exhibit booths, companies and organizations, Coca-Cola and others. Sometimes when you go to an event, they give out free pins. Also, inexpensive pins, you can go to eBay, secondhand pins, internet, handmade pins, buttons. In Amazon, you can get pins. Also, Pathfinder pins in the camperies. You can also get pins there and trade pins. You know, some clubs, they make their own pins, as you can see here, clubs. They have pins. When they go to Camperi, they make pins so they can trade in some places. Also, conference and union. And now I'm going to add general conference, divisions. Those levels of the churches, they do pins in for their events so people can remember and trade. And also, you will find vendors at camperies that sell pins and so on and so on. Some people in some clubs do fundraising. They know, they buy it for $1, they sell it for $150, they sell $1,000, so they get some money back and so on and so on. Okay, very good, very good. So miscellaneous pins. The following are some places where new pins are sold. Amusement park, aquariums, zoo, gift shops, internet, museum, stay on national parks, on truck stops, and so on, and so on, and so on. Walt Disney at the Olympics. You already mentioned that. Let's go to number five. Discuss at least five different methods of displaying your pins for trading. I already show you. You already know. It could be a scarf right here. You can put it in a frame. You can put it in a lanyard. You can put it on a vest. You can put it on a hat. And you can put it on a pin bag. I have a pin bag here that I need to organize it. I'm not going to lie to you. This is my pin bag. I need to organize it right here. This, you can put all the pins. This is my pin bag. I'm going to show you another picture right now. This is, you can see there. You can see the jacket there. The vest. I call it jacket, but it's a vest. The hat, the vest, and also a backpack. Some people use backpacks full of pins, and they put the pins inside and start threading in some places. Here's the bag, the bag, pin bag, and here is the lanyard. Okay? Very good. Also, cardboard. I've seen people put in cardboard, CD cases, fanny pack, felt square, stereo foam, paper plate. Even in a paper plate, people put it in and walk around sharing and giving away or trading. Okay, six, five venues or events where pin trading is popular activity. I'm going to go through it. I got 14 minutes, so I'm going to go through it quickly. Five venues. Anybody knows which venues can we go to get pins? Number one, Disneyland, or in some places called Walt Disney World. Disney has always offered collective Disney pin in each of its parks. But with the kickoff of the millennium, we can call it like that, celebration, was in October 1999. At Walt Disney World, they began a new tradition of Disney pin trading. Sorry. So now thousands of guests trade each with a cast member as well as other guests throughout the park and resorts. There are pins of the various attractions and character in the park, as well as anything else associated with Disney. Okay? So for this fish, if you want to go and have more information about this, you can Google or go to Disney go.com/eventservice/how-to-pin-trade. Or you can just Google a pin trade in Disney, so whatever, and you will find a lot of information in how everything began and the history of it. Also, the Little League Baseball, that's number two. Little League Baseball, they use pin trading after the game. That becomes something great. That becomes everybody after the game. Some people say at the Little League Baseball competition, there's more competition with pin trading than anything else. So people really enjoy doing pin trading at the Little League Baseball. In fact, the trading of baseball pins can get almost as competitive as the game itself, like I already said. You know, filling up a collection with the coolest pins around and has become a hobby for youth league players and parents alike. So I already mentioned at the Olympics, it is a tradition at this moment. A new pins are released each day of the Olympics. Listen to this. So I already mentioned in California, United States, in Pasadena tournament rows of game and parade, they do pin trading. And as I already mentioned, at Camp Paris, this one was in a Camp Paris that I was, and they did this puzzle. So each area, they bought their pins, so they need to trade other pins so they can get the whole puzzle. So everybody was fighting, and everybody was trying to have fun trading different pins so they can get the whole map, and they took the map home. It's very interesting. That's the map of Tuxtla Gutiérrez in Mexico, in the south in Mexico. Okay, I already mentioned this, but let's go quick. We almost finishing. Discuss the three F's of pin trading etiquette. You already know it. Fun, fair, and friendly. So it has to be fun. Look at Pastor Dejan showing his back at the World Congress in Germany. So I said, I need a handsome man. I need someone with strength. And on someone that is always fun. And I found his picture. So I put it there. I said, this is the man. So look, pin trading family, Pathfinder, it needs to be fun. Pin trading is about having fun. And it provides a great way to meet people and make some new friends. Remember, it's to make friends. Pin is about making friendship. So take a friend with you when trading. Take a friend. Younger children should always have an adult with them. Don't do it by yourself. If you're a minor, go with your friends or go with an adult, because sometimes pin training can become something interesting. If you are a minor, some people try to take advantage. So that has to do with etiquette. Some people try to take advantage. For example, they say, oh, this pin is very important. It's the best pin ever. So I give you this pin, and you give me 5 of your pins. No way, Jose. You need to know the value of your pin, and you need to know also their value. But don't get robbed, because I'm not going to lie to you. There are some people there that sometimes they misbehave, and they don't know how to do pin trading, and they want to take advantage of the younger generation. Don't allow that. This pin trading honor is to have fun. It is not fun to be pressured into a trade. It is only good to trade with both parties as satisfied after the trade. You both need to be satisfied after the trade. It is always acceptable to suggest another pin, or politely say no thanks if you are not happy with the proposed trade. So you need to know how to do it. Say, no, thank you. I like your pin, is beautiful, but I'm not willing to trade at this moment. Oh, I'm trading this one, but not this one, if you think it's not worth it. So that's why it needs to be fair. It needs to be fair. Some people take advantage of others. Lack of knowledge of pin trading. In general, you should expect to trade 1-for-1 when pins are approximately equal size of and quality. Trade one at a time, hand to hand, with the pins bags, okay, attached or closed. You need to do it, because some people, they don't love the Lord, they love the pins, so you know, they take advantage.
Yeah, that's right, Pastor. That's right. Some people need to meet Jesus before they meet pins.
Yes,
but you're absolutely right. We need to be careful as well. So that's a great advice.
So, you know, never steal a pin from anyone. Get your pin honestly, okay? Pins should be treated and traded, not bought or sold when you are pin trading, okay? So if you are into pin trading, you are into pin trading. If you want to buy pins, that's another time with another mentality. You know, you bargain there, can I buy this? But when you do pin trading, concentrate in pin trading. Because if you mix both, you will lose the joy and the fairness, okay? And you need to be friendly, okay? You need to be unfriendly. Smile and talk to the person you want to trade with. Speak with the same, if you speak the same language, find out their names and where they're coming from, and have fun. Get to know them. Even if you don't speak their language, you can still communicate and trade pink by smiling and pointing and nodding and shaking the hand and all that, okay? So it has to be friendly. There is one verse that we need to, before we finish, there is one verse that we need to meditate. And it's in Matthew 6:19-21. And it says, do not store up for yourself treasures on earth, where moths and vermin destroy, and where thieves and break in and steal. I'm sorry for my English. Remember, you know, I'm learning. But store up for yourself treasures in heaven, where moth and vermin do not destroy, and where thieves and do not break in steal. For where your treasure is, there your heart will beat also. This is about to have fun. This is to create friendship, but don't get crazy about it, okay? Everything will be destroyed. That's what the Bible says. So, you know, I'm going to store this, not because I wanted to take it to heaven. Like the Egyptians, they will, when they die, they will put all the treasure in their coffin, in the pyramid, in whatever they put them. So because they believe that when they go to the afterlife, they will get all those treasure, but it's not true. You saw how they found the Tutankhamun coffin full of gold and many, many millions of gold in gold, and he didn't take anything. He's dead, okay? So the Bible says the dead, not nothing. So please, you're not taking these. This is just for fun, okay? So last but not least, how can I trade and collect pins without giving up our focus on heaven? Trading and collecting pins can be a really fun hobby, but it's important to remember that pins are just things, and they will be destroyed at the end anyway. Okay? So how can pin trading help us to become more like Jesus? We can learn to see people the way Jesus sees them and to treat them the way Jesus will treat them. We can practice being kind, loving, helpful, patient, and polite as we trade in pins, because that is the way Jesus would be towards others. So what behavior and attitude should we avoid while pin trading? Selfish and greed is not acceptable. Trying to get a pin at any cost is not acceptable. Taking advantage of others, pressuring someone to make a trade, interrupting someone who is in the middle of a trade. Don't be rude, okay? Don't get a fight over a pin, a stealing. Don't get angry or upset if you don't get a pin you want. Lying of being deceptive about pins. Don't do that. So my family, this is the end. God bless you. Remember, you need to start trading pins with five people in a venue or with your friends so you can finish this honor, depending how the union also adapt this portion here, because this is really new. This is really new. God bless you. I love you all. I'll finish on time. And you have 3 minutes, 3 minutes to have your questions. God bless, and thank you.
Big thank you for your amazing presentation. We do have a few questions, and we do have a few suggestions, and certainly I want to say to everybody the next year, by God's grace, but next year we have a British Union Camp Re, but before that, we don't know, will this disease allow us to have a conference, a mission Camp Re, but certainly this is something that we would all love to be part of. And so, Pastor Andreas, somebody asked, do you know exact number of your pins in a collection?
Well, I have at least almost 10,000 pins in my house.
Somebody just mentioned, does your wife know exact?
Oh, those pins. No, she doesn't know.
Another question that came through as well is, which one is your favorite pin or favorite collection?
That is a very hard one. But I'm going to at least tell you that I believe this one, and people will kill me online because I'm going to say that, but I'm going to say it anyway. I'm going to tell you at least three of them, which I believe are the best ones. For me, this is one of them. I'm not saying the one, but one of them, the one in letters chosen. That yes. One is really nice. I think it's very creative. It's beautiful. Of course, I love this one. And this one was from a long time ago. I created this one. I'm not going to say it's my favorite, okay, because I would look selfish. This is another one that I like. I think it was very creative the first time I saw it, the drone, the one that I just gave.
That's right. Okay. The amazing girl got it, so we are so happy.
Excellent. That's the number two. That's the number two. And let me bring you, hold on, I'll give you another one here.
As Pastor Andreas is going to his vault to find the pin. It is. Oh, here it is.
Okay. This is a very simple one. A friend of mine made it. This was not an institution. It was a church member who made this one from Desmond Doss, this small one.
Yes, yes.
I did it on behalf of Desmond Doss, and I love his stories. For me, that is one that I really love. And in this one, I made this one a long time ago when I was a youth director. Not because I made it, but it what it means. Remember, it's not about beauty only.
Yes.
Or activity. It's also about meaning.
Yes.
When I had my leader's graduation, when I was a youth director in New York City, this was my first pin, and we graduated like 300 people in leadership, PLA, PIA, and all the directors in media and many things. This pin right here.
Yes.
That represents all the ministry that was in the conference. That was my first pin as a youth director. So really, that has a meaning. So, you know, I'll show you a couple of them. Okay, the chosen letters, the drone, my in that one.